I found this recipe in my Baking with Julia cookbook. And since I love lemons, and everybody I know loves the lemons, the happy fruit, and I had 8,000 lemons, I thought I'd do this. Usually when I have a glut of lemons, I make lemon meringue pie. But that's not what I'm doing today. So I'll show you what goes in it. Let 4 large eggs come to room temperature. And then I melted 5.5 tablespoons of unsalted butter and let it come to room temperature. The key is everything's at room temperature. Okay, so I've got eggs. I've got, in the bowl, I've got 1 3/4 cups. No, I don't. I have 1 1/3 cups of sugar and a pinch of salt, and I'm going to dump the eggs in. It's supposed to be an easy cake, but my phone hasn't stopped ringing. I mean, my regular phone, my cell phone, everything's going cuckoo. It says to whisk this, but don't make it get, you know, fluffy. It should be just mixed. Anyway, I can't get hold of any of my family members back east. They're probably buried in snow. I emailed the kids. Haven't heard from them. Texted my sister 42 times. Haven't heard from her. Now I'm going to call my other little sister and see if she's okay. I know they all have generators back there. Well, two of my brothers do. And, oh my gosh, my baby brother is in Minnesota right now. I wonder if he got clobbered. He was flying out when the storm started, so I don't know if he got delayed or anything. He was coming from Florida, which is where Dad and Mamacita are. And maybe they're okay because they're on the Gulf Coast. I don't know. But anyway, my brother and sister-in-law were on their way to Minnesota. I haven't heard from anybody, and I've got 5 brothers and sisters. I have 1 million cousins in Delaware. I have 1 million cousins in Rhode Island. I don't know. I don't know where they all could be. All right, let me get ready here with the rest of the stuff. Oh, yeah, and I put a pinch of salt in there. So it was a little foamy. And now it says whisk in the zest of those 3 ginormous lemons. Okay. Be back. I keep turning you off and on because I'm trying to save my batteries. I've used so many. Now we got to put the flour and baking powder in 3 additions. And just whisk it in. Just till it's blended. So that's 1, then half of this. Oh yeah, preheat your oven to 350, did I tell you that? I hope you can see what I'm doing. This whisk is painfully heavy to me. And then whisk, whisk, whisk until it's all completely and totally blended. Meanwhile, back at the farm, you're going to butter and flour a 9x5 loaf pan. Okay, let me get my other add-ins. I can smell that lemon. Well, my first mistake was the heavy cream. I didn't have it. This is 1/2 and 1/2 and a little buttermilk. Let's hope it works. If not, oh well. I'll put the mistakes up too. That's the kind of gal I am. Okay. Okay, now switch to a spatula. Oops. Whisk in, fold in, kind of, gently, the butter. Okay, I'm going to dump this in a pan. Okay, we're going to bake it in the center of the oven that you've preheated for a really long time. 50 to 60 minutes. Of course, I can't see. They rate these things so darn small. But, hey, it's 50 to 60 minutes. See you then. Too dark. It took 70 minutes, well, 68 minutes, for it to get just stuck on the poker. It was very soupy. Also, the middle of the oven, I never bake in the middle of the oven. Not usually, anyway. I do the lower middle of the oven. So this got too brown because it had to be in too long. But, my house smells so good. I've never been in a bakery that smells as good as my house. I can smell lemons in every room. I don't think I could bear the thought of waiting until tomorrow to taste it, because lemons are the happy fruit. Alrighty, we'll let you know how the tasting goes. Oh yeah, cool it 10 minutes in the pan on a rack, turn it out. Norman says you can eat it as soon as it's cool, but it might be improved by wrapping. So, I'm going to let it sit. Hungry will not let me keep it till tomorrow. He will dive into it tonight. When I checked it at 50 minutes, I covered it with foil. Too dark. I can't wait to dig into that. Except for the... Well, I don't mind that, but Hungry will say, "You burned it." No, I didn't. Norman Love did. Why? I think that the positioning of a center rack was out of whack. I can't tell you how good this smells and how good my whole entire house smells. In fact, the neighbors were outside chatting just a minute ago, walking the dog, and I heard one of them say, "What smells so good?" I'm not sharing. Lemony simple syrup. I used one of the big lemons and squeezed it in there with some simple syrup. Boil it for 4 minutes, and then I'm going to brush it on the cake. By the time I got stick to the skewer crumb, the cake, of course, is overdone. So it's very, very dry. Although it tastes very, very good. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just brush on some simple syrup. And I'll do that maybe twice. There it is. There it is. When you brush simple syrup on a cake and let it soak in, it does not make the cake too wet. I have made my secret chocolate cake recipe into cupcakes like 2 or 3 days before the event. And every night before I went to bed, I brushed plain simple syrup on it. All of them. And they came out just so good. I had a lot to make for that party, so. And then a neighbor had a death in the family, so. I journeyed a few hundred of those over there for their memorial service. Okay, so it's very well brushed. As I was saying before Flip digested my batteries, just brush it. It won't hurt it. I have done this for most pound cakey things. Like if you're making a special occasion cake, I always do this. Okay. Wrap her up and she'll be good for late night dessert. Because we're going to Dr. D's today. Yes, I know. It seems like I go once a week. I do go once a week.